Latter-day Trumpet. This video is part of our second series of presentations about the Book of Mormon. Because the prophet Joseph Smith taught the early church leaders that the Lehigh colony landed in South America, we have created this series of videos. Our theories and research is based on the truths from the Book of Mormon, but should not be considered as official church doctrine. The Jaredites by L. Norman Shurtleff. At the end of the Book of Mormon, Moroni abridges the plates of ether that King Mosiah first translated when the Nephites arrived in Zarahemla. The last Jaredite king, King Coriantumr, lived with the Mulekites for 9 moons or 9 months before he died. It was the end of a great civilization to the north of Zarahemla that occupied both sides of the narrow neck of land. The destruction of this whole civilization ended in a terrible civil war where millions of people perished. The record starts at the ancient Tower of Babel, 2200 to 2500 BC, in what is now the area of Baghdad, Iraq. Jared came forth with his brother and their families from the great tower at the time when the Lord confounded their language and scattered the people. This Tower of Babel, in what was anciently Babylon, was essentially 2200 years before Christ. And the brother of Jared, being a large and mighty man, and a man highly favored of the Lord, Jared his brother, said unto him, "Cry unto the Lord, that he may not confound us, we may not understand our words." Ether 1, verse 34. So the brother of Jared did cry unto the Lord, and the Lord had compassion on them, and did not confound the language of Jared and his brother, and their friends and their family. And the Lord also promised them that if they would be faithful, he would lead them to a promised land. Next, the Lord commanded them to gather their flocks and herds and animals. The record states the following: "Go to and gather thy flocks, both male and female, of every kind, and also the seed of the earth of every kind, and thy families, and also Jared and thy brother and his family, and also their friends and their families, and the friends of Jared and their families. And I will go before thee into a land which is choice above all the lands of the earth." Here are more South American animals that are native to South America. "And they did also lay snares and catch fowls of the air. And they did also prepare a vessel in which they did carry with them the fish of the waters. And they did also carry with them Deseret, which by interpretation is a honeybee. And thus they did carry with them swarms of bees and all manner of that which was upon the face of the land, seeds of every kind. So they took with them Deseret, or swarms of honeybees." The brother of Jared received this revelation from the Lord as he talked with them and gave him instructions as they traveled. "Behold, this is a choice land, and whatsoever nation shall possess it shall be free from bondage and from captivity and from all other nations under heaven, if they will but serve the God of the land, who is Jesus Christ, who hath been manifested by the things which we have written." Ether 2, verse 12. The Lord instructed the brother of Jared and his group how to build boats that were watertight in the shape of a dish. The boats were long as a tree and closed with a lid to let the air in when the seas were calm. They made 8 vessels, but were completely dark inside. So the brother of Jared molted 16 small stones that were white and clear as transparent glass. This is one of the greatest parts of the Book of Mormon, the lessons on faith that Moroni teaches us from the story of the brother of Jared, seeing the finger of the Lord touching the transparent stones is marvelous. The faith of the brother of Jared was so strong that he could not be kept within the veil, and the Lord showed him all, including his premortal body. The Jaredites were righteous and worshiped God and became his covenant people and built a huge civilization in the promised land. This civilization began at the time of the Tower of Babel, 2200 BC, and continued into the Nephite and Mulekite eras. They landed just north of Zarahemla at a distance of a journey of just many days and south of the narrow neck of land. But eventually their people and cities covered the whole face of the land. Unfortunately, the people became wicked and terrible civil wars ravaged the land. The greatest civilization that the Lord had ever established was decimated, and Coriantumr was the last remaining man and was discovered by the Mulekites. Ether, The prophet witnessed the destruction and finished his record. He had to hide in the cavity of a rock for his safety as he wrote and finished the record and then left it in a place where the Nephites and Mulekites could find it. Then if this civilization was so huge and incredible, then there must be evidences today of the Jaredite culture from that time period. We know where they landed, according to the Book of Mormon. Today, we know the Jaredites are the Olmec Civilization in northern Peru and Ecuador. The cultures are combined to be Mochi, Caral, Chanchan, Chimu, and Chavandehuantar, and the Manipi culture, to name a few. We look at examples of these ancient ruins. We will look at examples of these ancient ruins in the next part of this presentation, but we will start with the evidences of animals like the cameloids that the ancient Jaredites, now the Olmec Civilization, brought with them to the Promised Land. We'll first start with the family of cameloids brought over by the Jaredites, which are now considered native to South America. Here is a picture of llamas, which was the universal pack animals for the Inca Empire. Alpacas were bred for meat and also for their wonderful wool to make their world-famous textile. The vicunas were left in a wild state to be hunted by the royal families only. These beautiful animals had a wonderful fleece that was privileged and prized above all. Their wool could only be used by the royal Inca family. The South American guinea pig was domesticated to be a children's pet and also for meat for the family. The mighty mountain lion or puma to the small honeybee or Deseret. The Promised Land was repopulated again with animals. Herds of domestic animals like the cow, goat, sheep, donkeys, horses were all grown that were most useful to man. A quick focus on the honeybee needs to be made. Honeybees are not native to North America, but have all been imported from Europe and Africa. I personally am allergic to bees, and so the prospects of being enclosed in a vessel for a year on the ocean with swarms of honeybees frightens me to death. However, this ancient strain of honeybee was stingerless, with origins in Mesopotamia, so it could not sting the Jaredites on their voyage. Today, we can still find this small stingerless honeybee only in South America. It is not a common commercial strain because it is only a third the size of our modern-day hybrids and only produces a third of the amount of honey, so it is not economically used by bee apiaries and commercially. A DNA study links them to their cousins in the Middle East today. We will take a closer look at the various Olmec ruins that still exist and have survived nature's destruction over time. Here's a map of the general location of some of these ruins in northern Peru and southern Ecuador in purple. The Hoary Empire or Olmec Civilization. Here are various man-made pyramids and mud brick structures at Caral in the Supe Valley. This is the amphitheater at Caral, which is located 200 kilometers north of Lima, Peru, or Zarahemla. These ruins still exist today and are 2,000 years old, mostly because it rarely rains in the deserts along the coast of Peru. A bit further north, we find the Mochi ruins, huge colossal structures made over the centuries with millions of clay bricks. In the foreground can be seen the foundations of many other buildings and structures that have long since been reduced to ruins by the ravages of time. Inside the main structure or temple are beautifully carved motifs and human pictorials. Many of these carvings have yet to be properly studied and interpreted, but the stone carving is extremely beautiful. Further north still is Chanchan, which is a huge collection of very interesting buildings of unique design. Another picture of Chanchan shows the enormity of this immense city and the beautiful carvings and curious workmanship of the building. The Chimu culture is another immense ruin of beautiful design and majesty. This is a picture of the entrance into the temple square. The entrance into this impressive ruin at Chimu is quite magnificent, with intricately carved motifs. Chimu is a magnificent city with impressive architecture and workmanship that has withstood the natural pressures of time. These ruins are simply breathtaking. They are probably the most impressive Olmec culture ruins that still exist today. The Olmec ruins of Chavandehuantar are very old and very impressive as well. They have a distinct beauty of their own. Here is another view of the main temple of Chavandehuantar. star. Here is a model of the layout of the city complex. The Olmec culture is probably the most famous for their iconic stone heads that have similar appearance in many locations. These stone heads are now mostly found in museums, but can be found in Central America and Mexico, signifying that the Olmecs migrated to these areas from their motherland of Peru and their first landing area. There are many ruins, and most of them have not been properly studied or excavated, so we cannot present but a few here. But the last one we will show is the Manabi culture near Manta, Ecuador. It is a very large complex with a main temple at the high point of a hill in the center. The ruins of Manabi are vast, and mostly just the foundation stones of this large city are all that is left. The museums are filled with golden artifacts and jewelry that have been found in the excavations of these sites. They are made with beautiful craftsmanship and artistry. The most famous is the Chumu ceremonial knife that was used in their rituals and sacrifices. In conclusion, the Lord shared his vision of the promised land with the Jaredites so that he could raise up a righteous nation and a covenant people. This was the promise in the Book of Mormon to all who would be led to the promised land. And inasmuch as ye shall keep my commandments, ye shall prosper, and shall be led to a land which I have prepared for you, yea, a land which is choice above all other land. 1 Nephi chapter 2 verse 20. That land, of course, was the highlands of South America, which became the mother civilization of all three of the major groups that migrated or were led to the promised land by the Savior himself. They needed to keep his commandments, and he would prosper them in this good land. He never forgot them and visited them to further teach his children the gospel, showing that he loves his people wherever he has led them.